Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Let's look at cropping video and photos in iMovie. So I'm using iMovie version 10 here, and let's take a look at how cropping works, because a lot of people get tripped up with this. So in this example here, I've got a bunch of clips, and you can see these first few clips here are in 16:9 format, which is the same format as my project. And it's the format most people use for video now. But I have an older clip here that's a 4:3, and you can see there it's almost looks square compared to this. So you're going to see a difference when I try to bring these into the timeline. Let me go and just bring this into the timeline here, and I will then bring this in after it. And you can see that they both fill the area here, but it's definitely cropping here. You can see that the top and the bottom, compared to when I just look at the clip here, and now I look at it in the project, it's clipping off the top and the bottom to stretch it so that the sides of the video stretch all the way across. Now I have some choice when it comes to this. I can select this here and go to adjust and select cropping. You can see it's already indicating that it's doing some cropping here. And you can see exactly what part of the video is going to be visible in my project. Now if I want, I can drag this up and down, so I can move it. So say if it's more important I see the video at the top, or more important I see it at the bottom. I can even drag the edges here so I can focus on a certain portion of the video. And of course, if I want to, I could drag it to be larger than the area here, and that's going to give me black bars on the left and right, because there's simply no video there for it to show. So if I select this as being what I want, then I close the adjustment window there, I can see that I've got those black bars, and that's how it's going to show this video. So it's kind of my choice. If I want to see more at the top or the bottom, I'm going to have black bars on left and right, because there's simply nothing else there to show. Now back in the cropping options, I do have the option to say fit, and what fit will do is it will make it fit so the entire video is visible, which is going to give me the maximum black bars on the left and right here in order to make sure that the top and the bottom of the video fit in place. I can also, of course, choose the Ken Burns effect, which will allow me to animate from one to the other. So I can animate from a starting position to an ending position here, and as I scrub across the bottom, after I close the adjustment here, I can see it. You can see it going from one cropping to another cropping. Now you're going to run into this whenever you try to use a 4:3 video like this one in a 16:9 project, but it's going to happen even more commonly when you go and try to bring in a photo, because photos in general are not 16:9. So let's bring in a photo here, and I'm going to bring that in, and it's going to, by default here, my project is going to assign the Ken Burns effect, but let's change that. We can either do fit, which is going to create black bars at the left and right, or you can do crop as before, and then we can adjust the cropping. Now this works a little bit better with photos, because photos are usually a much higher resolution than video. So even if I decide to crop and pick a smaller area there, I'm going to end up with pretty good quality, because there's plenty of pixels for it to choose from to zoom in on that spot. But there is no way for me to show the entire image without having black bars. That's just not possible. If I choose fit, it's going to show those black bars, because in order to get the top and the bottom, it's going to have nothing on the left and right to show in that space.